in for a look at a few. He's got his eye on it, thinks we should as well. Bill, welcome. We started off the show looking at the volatility in the indices, but Bitcoin has also experienced a volatile start to the week.
Yeah, you're getting a big big sell-off. And you know, there's been times where it's not uncommon to see Bitcoin come in a little bit after the weekend, gets a little pump up through the weekend. But this is probably a little bit more. You see celebrities all over the internet talking about cryptocurrencies. You got El Salvador right now making an official cryptocurrency attaching to Bitcoin. I haven't really dove into those details so much. If it's been such a hectic day in the markets in general, I just know that 50K was a target of mine to the upside, really 47.5 at Bitcoin. And I was expecting to see a little bit of a pullback. I didn't know when it would happen, but I felt it started to get a little frothy. There's a lot of names. One thing I was keeping a pulse on in the altcoin space, you know, you get the moves in Bitcoin, move in Ethereum, and then you start to see these altcoins start to move. And the altcoins weren't really moving when they should have. So that sort of laid the groundwork for this pullback. I had some different investments and just different names across the board, like a Polkadot or a Sushi, that I started taking off last night, actually. But my favorite really is Solana. And I'd love to see that pullback to about $80 or $100. I love that. I think it's Ethereum's market cap is still about 10 times the size of Solana. Probably a little bit less than that now, but I think we're going to see them become comparative. I think we're going to see Solana make a move towards that. So it's not necessarily investment advice. I have to say that because the regulators, but know what you're investing in. But I really do like Solana in the long run.
Bitcoin futures gapping up and through that 50-day moving average. We're talking towards the end of July. It's really yet to look back. Again, volatile session today. The futures did spike up into the high 53,125, the low 43,000. We're talking almost $1,000 in range, water range to say the least. So let's move on. Let's talk a couple individual stocks you've got your eye on. We were looking at some Dow weakness at the top of the show. A couple laggards there stood out. Coke, J&J, saw Boeing also coming under pressure. What do you have your eye on?
You know, I think let's start with Coke. It hasn't done what it should have. I mean, it's the staples have really kind of outpaced it. It's Pepsi broke out above 150, and Coca-Cola has been left in the dust. And it hasn't even taken out Coca-Cola. Look back at February 2019 was a really great performer, and it really kind of melted into the COVID, and then it fell off, and it hasn't been able to get out above there. So I mean, I don't own Pepsi right now. I have owned it recently, but I think you could, reason to be long Pepsi above 150. But to the point, and one of the reasons why the Coca-Cola stock has lagged is you're not getting the restaurants, the demand from there. You're not getting the stadium demand. But did you see those college football games this weekend? And a lot of those stadiums are looking a lot more packed than they were last year. I'll be betting a lot of home teams this year. It's a little different. But I think you get some of that demand come back in, and that could be a catalyst. I don't see a reason really to be invested in right now, though.
Coke coming back off of a recent high up around the $58 level, it looks like. It's been in a bit of a range here, and it's retesting the lower extreme of that range right now. I think, again, the weakness here should be concerning. Bill, you mentioned Pepsi. I've got them both here side by side. And actually, Pepsi did take out those highs from the end of July. We're talking when Coke got up to 58 to begin the month of August, but followed through was somewhat limited. And both have actually come back down here. This range may be a little bit more well-defined in Pepsi. So something to watch here in terms of a lower extreme on these names. Let's move on, because we also pointed out at the top of the show how we saw some strength in terms of some of the tech names. Interestingly enough, recently Facebook in a new all-time high. We've been watching Alphabet today. Netflix, that's actually my chart of the day. They're into a new all-time high. We've got, again, some of the big, closely watched FANG names and, the NDX outperformance in general today. What stands out, Bill?
Well, Netflix, in hindsight, I mean, it really was such a nice move from about 550, 570 when it started pumping. Upside, you can look at that maybe as high as 650, but I think 625 was with the range retracement from an area. Now, I think that was interesting. You're seeing Disney move up following that. Disney leading, kind of helping the Dow hold together a bit better. Dow's, I think, down about 200 points. But Disney raised Hulu prices, getting some of the Netflix tailwinds. I think, those obviously did well. Amazon, Tesla. Tesla's been one that I've liked it a lot. I thought after some of the news a couple weeks ago, it was going to lag, but it's really shown its stripes here, and it's getting good buying momentum. And then, of course, Apple with the news and the iPhone 13 watches ahead of September 13th, event. So you're getting some of the names that may have not really stood out so much from Amazon, a Tesla, and Apple from about 2 weeks ago. They're really moving up over the past week and have sort of led, and they're continuing to lead. And that's why you're seeing FANG outperform. You're seeing the NASDAQ outperform as well.
I like it. Apple on the move here. If we could just pull the daily time frame so we could see the breakout up through the 150 level. Again, a nice move higher. We're talking on the 31st of August and really continuation throughout the month of September so far. Bill, thanks for giving us part of your Tuesday afternoon to start the week here on the TD Ameritrade Network. Bill Baruch, the president of Blue Line Futures, joining us to dive into some of the volatility in Bitcoin and some of the stock price activity we've seen that stood out in terms of large